Okay, thank you. Well, I'm also going to talk about earlier tea initiation, but it's in a different context in South Sudan. I'm going to present the implementation of our test and treat program. Well, South Sudan, just for an introduction to the context, South Sudan got independent in 2011, and since December 2013, a civil war has been going on with an important ethnic component. The region most affected by the conflict is the northern eastern part of the country, but in 2015, clashes spread to Western Equatorial region, which is in the southern part of the country, affecting locations like Yambio, Mundri, and Esso. This region had been a relatively peaceful area until last year. MSF Operational Center Barcelona is present in the Upper Nile region, where they have projects taking care of internally displaced people. And also in Western Equatoria, in Yambio, where we were supporting the district hospital until last year, and this is where we started our test and treat program. Regarding HIV situation, South Sudan is a country with a low prevalence of HIV, 2.7%, but in some regions this prevalence is higher, especially in Western Equatoria, which has the highest prevalence in the country, almost 7%. We find very centralized HIV counseling and testing services, as well as access to antiretroviral therapy, which is only available at district hospital level. So we can already say that reaching 90-90-90 in this context is a big challenge. That's why we came with this idea of project to try to bring HIV counseling and testing and ART closer to the communities. Also implementing an early ART initiation, because we want to assess the feasibility and acceptability of this intervention in this context. So the location we choose for our project is Western Equatoria former state, including rural areas of Yambio County, including three payams. These payams are the second lowest administrative division in South Sudan, with a total population estimated at almost 50,000 people. To develop this project, we carry out different activities. We basically organize mobile clinics around all these rural areas in Yambio County to offer counseling and testing to the population reaching our clinics. And when we find a positive patient, we offer the possibility to start ART that same day. Most of the patients that have been initiated, that was same day initiation, but it's true that we have a few patients that decided to come back later, some weeks or even months. And then we arrange with our patients to organize mobile clinics, not necessarily in the location they were tested, but still in the community, to do the follow-up and the drug refill. We have an important component of health education and mobilization with community health workers to make the population aware of our services and to spread health education messages. Also, since we are in an unstable context, we have a contingency plan. This contingency plan consists of different activities that are based on different levels of security. The levels of security come with the for all the projects in the country regarding different criteria or observations. At level one of security would be like the normal situation. We already give our patients a phone number they can call in case they run out of drugs or they have any problem. And already in our pharmacy, we keep a contingency stock. Level two of security, we might find already some areas with restriction of movements. So we would move with our community health workers to refill the drugs of these patients. And also we give an extra month to our patients to keep as a security buffer. Level three, there is already high tension, so there can be an open armed conflict. We cannot run our normal activities because of security, but we still need to assure the treatment of our patients. So we would organize distribution of runaway bags containing 3 months of ARVs, also through our community health workers. And at level 4 and level 5, the security situation is very dangerous and an evacuation might be planned. So at this time, we can just try to donate our drugs to the district hospital and hand over files and register. Today, I'm going to present the data from our program for the first 6 months. We just started in July last year. So from July to December 2015, I'm going to present some data regarding acceptability of the services based on the uptake on the HIV counseling and testing and the RT initiation. Some data about our patient outcomes, how many patients will remain in care at the end of the period. Also, we are collecting data from the lab, CD4 count and viral load at baseline and follow up after ART initiation. Today, I will just show the CD4 count at baseline. And our study was approved by the MSF and the South Sudan Ministry of Health Ethics Review Boards. Well, during these first 6 months, we tested 5,262 people with a positivity rate of 3.4%. And we initiated 146 patients, 82% of these positive patients. Out of them, 79 had a CD4 count less than 500 cells. At the end of the period, in December, we still had in care 140 patients. We had registered 3 loss to follow up, 3 transferred to other clinics, and no deaths. Unfortunately, we also had the chance to implement our contingency plan. In September 2015, the conflict started in the southern part of Yambio, when a fight between local militia and the army from the government started. And this area was declared a no-go area because of security. We had already initiated 21 patients, and we kept them on follow-up with the help of our community health worker. We kept 19 of them. Yes. Then in December 2015, there was intense gun shooting in Yambio during a few days. We stopped our activities, and we passed to level 3 of security, and we needed to organize distribution of runaway bags, thinking of a possible evacuation. We prioritized the patients needing refill at that time. So we distributed runaway bags to 25 of 29 patients with appointment that week, which is the 86%. Again, we restarted our activities. We came back to level 2 of security, but again, at the end of the month, again, classes in 2 locations to the west of Yambio interrupted our activities, and we needed to follow up some patients. We organized drug distribution to 51 of 56 patients needing refill, again with our community health workers. Well, as conclusions, we find that there is a high level of acceptance of this intervention in the community. Regarding the HIV counseling and testing and ART initiation, we could say that with this strategy, we're helping to bridge the gap of the first 2 90s. It's true that we need a contingency plan in this context, and we're quite happy with the outcomes of the implementation. But security situation is still a big limitation because there is not only we cannot reach those locations, but also there is the displacement. There is this claim, and it can be more difficult to find our patients, etc. We had a quite good number of patients remaining in care at the end of the period, but it's a short period, and we still need longer evaluation, including data about virological suppression, to come up with some guides, some ideas that could help for further MSF interventions focused on conflict settings with weak or non-existent HIV services. I just want to thank to all the people that make Test and Treat possible, especially to the to the staff on the field and the communities of Yambio.